Hey, what's up? This is Antonio. Welcome back to my channel. Now, who's ready for some fighting words? In this video, I want to talk about Ryan Garcia. I want to talk about Oscar De La Hoya and the legend himself, Manny Pacquiao, who will be coming out of retirement. Really quick, if you like the videos, please take the time right now, subscribe to the channel. Also, if you get that thumbs up button, it really does help support and further along this channel. So let's talk about this. So Manny Pacquiao is very content on coming back to boxing. Guys like him do not stay away. I mean, look at Floyd. Floyd can't stay away. He just must be in some type of contact with somebody in a ring. These guys, I don't know how long they can do this, but they both look good. They're both fast. Manny Pacquiao just can't stay away. Manny Pacquiao is taking more of a risk than Floyd Mayweather. I will say that. He's actually fighting real boxers. But on top of that, he's fighting young prime real boxers, which is very dangerous for him. He's been out of you know, the ring for some time. I mean, the last time that he fought was DKU, which was an exhibition, in which case Manny Pacquiao played with him and toyed with him and could have finished him at any given time. But instead, he was having way too much fun just toying with him. So that really doesn't count anything with me. You know, before that, it was Ugas, which was the fight that darn near took his life. Yeah, I mean, he looked really bad after the fight, and he was being spoon-fed by his wife. So here's the plus side to this fight, because obviously you're looking at a guy who's, you know, has had a lot of wear and tear on his body, but also, you know, is much older and has retired and has been inactive for quite some time, versus a guy who's young, fit, prime, strong, has not had any, you know, sustainable injuries or anything like that. Okay, but Ryan Garcia just moved up from 136. Manny Pacquiao has been fighting at 47, you know, 50, whatever. You know what I'm saying? So, like, that would be the, I don't want to say it's the catch right there, but it is sort of a catch. You know, that Manny Pacquiao is used to fighting bigger, stronger guys. So, that's the catch. However, in fighting Ryan Garcia, this is probably going to be the fastest guy that Manny Pacquiao has ever fought. Now, granted, he's fought Floyd Mayweather, but that was so long ago. And quite frankly, that's a complete and total contrast of styles with Ryan Garcia. Now, who do I think could win? And, well, let me, before I say that, I don't know why Golden Boy wants this fight. I really don't. I don't see how this further alongs not Oscar. I don't understand how Oscar De La Hoya can say this will help Ryan Garcia's career. Because it doesn't mean anything if he beats Manny Pacquiao. Because the reality is, you, like myself, we're all just going to say, well, Manny Pacquiao was old and hasn't been in a ring for many years now. So that doesn't mean anything if you beat him. But also, let's just say if you beat him, that doesn't move you up the ladder to getting belts or anything like that. So if this is just a money grab, call it what it is. It's just a money grab. It's a money fight. Both guys bring a lot of people to the table. I mean, the reality is either what guy can fill out an arena. Ryan Garcia truly showed his star power and his draw power in putting butts in seats with Gervonta Tank Davis. So I can only imagine with, you know, a living legend, Manny Pacquiao, you put him, who knows what they're going to fill out. But again, what does this accomplish or where does this get you at the end of the day? I don't think it gets him where he wants. And one of the things that the Gervonta Tank Davis fight showed me about Ryan Garcia is I don't think he has the heart that I once gave him credit for. I don't think he has that heart. So when he was dropped, you know, before in the past, he got back up and a dog came out. But when Gervonta Tank Davis dropped him, something else came out of him. And it was a lack of assuredness. He wasn't very confident, and that look of determination vanished from his face. And let me tell you, if Gervonta Tank Davis put you in that state of disbelief, what do you think Manny Pacquiao is going to do? Because Manny Pacquiao is a whole lot more active. He's going to throw a whole lot more punches, and he hits a lot harder than Gervonta Tank Davis. So I don't know what you're thinking. He's going to be throwing from crazy angles all over the place, 4, 5, 6 punch combinations, and you I hope you're not just going into this looking at a hook. Now, granted, Ryan Garcia is really fast, and granted, he has perfected that hook. It is a very dangerous weapon for him, but I think he's going to need a little bit more than that, to be honest with you. Even with somebody who's past his prime, even with somebody who has been out of step and out of date because he has not been in the ring, but still, I don't necessarily think that's going to cut it. Now, the great news for Ryan Garcia in this possible matchup with Manny Pacquiao would be that he's with Derek James. And he's in Texas. And he has people like Earl Spence to spar with. And he has sparred Earl Spence. I do know that for a fact. He's sparred him already. And it could be a very consistent thing, especially if he's looking to take on Manny Pacquiao. Because he would need somebody like an Earl Spence who applies a lot of pressure, who throws a lot of punches, and who has a lot of cardio. Much like Manny Pacquiao. So it would make sense to spar somebody like Earl Spence. Does he move like a Manny Pacquiao? No, he doesn't have to. Does he hit hard? Yes. Does he hit often? Very often. And can he go for 12 rounds straight? Absolutely. Just like Manny Pacquiao. So, I mean, there are a lot of factors. Yeah, I think it... I don't necessarily think it puts Ryan Garcia in star status. I don't think that. But I think it just puts more eyes on him. And I think if he were to ask for another Gervonta Tate Davis fight, I think he could get it just on star power if he were to beat Manny Pacquiao. He could also ask for Devin Haney and more than likely get that fight if he were to beat Manny Pacquiao. Right now, I'm not saying he's at the bottom of the barrel because he draws a lot of attention. So when you draw a lot of attention, you're never truly at the bottom of the barrel. Perfect example of that would be Manny Pacquiao. Manny Pacquiao can get knocked out and still sell another arena the next night. It doesn't matter. You know, so we will find out if Ryan Garcia is of the same. But I'm pretty sure he is because his social media following hasn't left him just because he had the loss. You know, there's a lot of people who are giving him a lot more credit because he took on Gervonta Tate Davis, especially when he didn't have to. That was of his calling. That's something that he desired. And I'm pretty sure nobody in their right mind, especially in his camp, wanted that for him. But that's something that he desired. So he got what he wanted. And it looks like he might get what he wants again in fighting Manny Pacquiao. He did mention this fight years ago, but he wasn't ready. I don't think he's ready now. But again, the factor in this fight is Derek James. The factor in this fight is Texas. The factor in this fight is the stable that Derek James has. He also has Frank Martin over there. That would not hurt, you know, Ryan Garcia as a sparring partner. It wouldn't hurt him at all. In fact, it would greatly benefit him because now we're talking about somebody who has the height of a Manny Pacquiao. You're talking about somebody who's very compact, who throws a lot of punches like a Manny Pacquiao. Great defense. So I think he can give him a lot of looks. And I think between somebody like him and somebody like an Earl Spence, I think we can get Ryan Garcia in solid enough shape and possibly get his confidence back to where he could be competitive with Manny Pacquiao. I do see Manny Pacquiao winning. Yes, even at this stage, I see Manny Pacquiao winning. There's a lot of tricks and a lot of setups that Manny Pacquiao does. His footwork alone, Ryan Garcia doesn't have the best footwork. In fact, he doesn't really have any footwork. So Manny Pacquiao's footwork, Manny Pacquiao's double jab, Manny Pacquiao's angles would definitely be a problem. Manny Pacquiao's cardio, Manny Pacquiao's punch output, all these things are going to be a huge factor. And quite frankly, I don't feel like Derek James can get, but it all depends on when this fight were to happen. But let's say if this fight were to happen within the next 6 months, I don't think Derek James can get Ryan Garcia fit enough to handle the problem that is Manny Pacquiao. Nor do I think he can get Ryan Garcia mentally strong enough to endure somebody like a Manny Pacquiao for 12 rounds. I don't think so. I really don't think so. Manny Pacquiao is relentless. He's a very tenacious fighter, and he's not going to let up. He has a ton of heart. He's been down before, and he is a true champion through and through. There's a reason why he's a legend. And I just don't see Ryan Garcia, especially at this stage, beating a Manny Pacquiao. And I don't care about his age. I don't care that he's been inactive. I just don't see it. But those are my thoughts. Drop your thoughts down below. I'd love to hear what you have to say. What do you think about Ryan Garcia taking on Manny Pacquiao. Do you think it's a good thing for Manny Pacquiao or a bad thing? Drop your thoughts down below. As always, I'd love to hear what you have to say. Please like, please share, please subscribe to this channel.